resistant superbug is now here in the United States.
Antibiotic resistance.
Antibiotic resistance.
This is antibiotic resistance.
And antibiotic resistance.
Antibiotic resistance. 23,000 here in the United States. 2 million infections.
Brandon and I met back in 2007. She was in the Future Farmers of America. She was a state officer. I was a production manager. When I met her, I didn't even realize that she had anything. She was just a normal person. Happy-go-lucky. Her smile was bigger than any smile I've ever seen in my life.
I think the public should recognize that if they are careless with antibiotics, the way that they consume them, that that can have an effect on them in the future. Their own family, their own safety can be threatened, and certainly the safety of the community as well. I want to make it clear, today in the United States, we can still treat most bacterial infections that we encounter. That may require IV treatment, it may require hospitalization, it may require surgery, amputation of a limb. We can still usually save lives, but not always, and it will not stay that way.
This could be the end to antibiotics as we know them.
Drug-resistant bacterial infections are on track to kill more people than cancer.
Health officials say antibiotic overuse is a public health threat in the U.S.
This is the drug which has already saved the lives of hundreds of men seriously wounded on the battlefield, which has revolutionized medical science.
So I noticed something that perhaps others had missed, and that observation 25 years ago has got us...
In 1928, a lucky accident sparked one of the greatest discoveries in medical history. However, in Alexander Fleming's Nobel lecture, he warned against the carelessness of the public that had the potential to take away the life-saving discovery he had made.
So antibiotic resistance is not a modern phenomenon, it's not a new thing. It's been with us since we started using antibiotics. It's something that we expect. What we have not expected is this out-of-control use of antibiotics worldwide that has really accelerated the process of antibiotic resistance.
21 million pounds of antibiotics fed to healthy animals on farms to promote growth are teaching bacteria to outsmart antibiotics, creating drug-resistant strains of infections like staph.
And so by countries putting antibiotics in the feed for the animals, that's increasing the exposure to the bacteria of those drugs. And resistance can develop from that and spread to the infections that people then will get. And those antibiotics will not be effective for killing those bugs in the future.
At 3 years old, she was told that she had, with her, you know, complications of breathing and such as a kid, cystic fibrosis, what she was diagnosed with. And it wasn't until all of a sudden her lung function dropped to almost about 50%. And that was because of what the doctors over in Spokane thought to identify with the Mycobacterium abscessus.
Antibiotic resistance isn't just a projection for the future. It's already here. In Bangladesh, a pandemic of highly resistant bacteria has killed thousands of young children by causing a deadly strain of pneumonia.
Our attitude towards antibiotics has changed over time in that what was once back then probably a complete miracle is now a normal part of our lives. And we don't really think too much about what would happen if those miracle was suddenly taken away from us.
With antibiotics, it may take months, years, or decades for us to see the reverberations of our decisions or our failure to make decisions today. This is why it's hard. I want you to think of antibiotic resistance the way you think of climate change, right? So just as we are now seeing our world burn on fire, it's taken a long time to get to this point, so too with antibiotic resistance. Just as we're running out of gasoline, so too we're running out of good antibiotics.
We risk
being in a post-antibiotic world. And that wouldn't just be for infections that you think of as bad infections, pneumonia and urinary tract infections. That's bad enough. That could be for the 600,000 Americans a year who need cancer treatment, for whom we just assume we'll be able to treat infections. We may lose that ability.
Numbers started to dwindle very quickly. You know, lung transfer, transplant was talked about, but then it was too far along. And then, you know, it got to a point where the drugs were just not holding anything back. Finally, after about 2 weeks in the hospital, we brought her home, and she had about 3 days of, you know, we had her on oxygen, and we left the drugs at the hospital so we could go home free. But after about 3 days, her lungs finally gave, and she passed.
So it's a very real issue. It's not something that's happening in the future or happening somewhere else. It's happening here, in your community, in the United States, and also elsewhere around the world.
Antibiotic resistance was the extreme battle of Brianna. That's simply what took her life, is, you know, the antibiotics no longer being as effective as they were as the first time they were used.
So my hope is that people will start to think about this, plan for the future, invest in this problem, and also take some very simple personal steps that we've talked about in their own lives to help to manage this problem.
And what I would like people to know about antibiotic resistance is that we all have a part to play in this if we want antibiotics to work for our grandchildren. Remember that what you take affects what others can take. We need to be good stewards of this responsibility. We're all in this together, and together we're better partners in prevention of these resistant organisms. Mm-hmm.